Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the Chetwynd Secondary School Leaving Ceremony. We respectfully acknowledge the history, spirituality, and culture of the First Nations people within Treaty 8 was signed and the territory wherein our school resides. As we begin today, we ask that you please turn off your cell phones at this point. As we introduce the members of the class of 2020, please feel free to take photographs as each graduate makes their way to the stage. At this point, I would like to ask Mrs. Henry, our MC, to join me at the podium and welcome the students to the stage.
Donovan Wheeler. Dustin Hayward. Davis Schmidt. Mitchell Rodenbush. Kate Leonis. Tristan Gary. Cody Gary. Just Embathy Ingalls. Madison Webb. Olivia Beamish. Hayden Waldy. Madison Beamish. Ladies and gentlemen, the class of 2020. I would now like to ask Mr. Mould to lead us in the singing of our national anthem. Will you all please rise?
Oh, Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all our sons command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true north strong and free. From far and wide, oh Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. Oh Canada, we stand on guard for thee. Oh, Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
Thank you. Please be seated. Good day, ladies and gentlemen, family and friends. We are here to honor these young men and women as they move into a new and exciting stage of their lives. We are pleased and privileged to have messages from several special guests. Some of these guest speakers will only be on your USB that you will receive.
Good afternoon or good evening. On behalf of the Board of Education for School District 59, Peace River South, thank you for inviting us to be here with you today. We hope that your educational experience from School District 59 has filled you with a sense of pride, and this year, more than ever, we applaud the determination that has led to this accomplishment. You are the first graduating class to navigate multiple changes to education all within that final stretch to grad. And we can assure you that the dedication that you have shown these past few months will serve you well in the future. Although these last few months have been historic, it has been your hard work throughout your whole educational journey that has led to today's success. While our ceremonies look quite different this year, please know that your family, friends, and community are all gathering with a great sense of joy and pride as you cross the stage today.
As you enter the next chapter of your lives, you'll be entering a world undergoing rapid change, economically, politically, socially, and culturally. Graduates know that you have a voice that is being heard on a global scale. As many around the world are seeking equity, acceptance of diversity and inclusion, don't be caught standing still. Be your own champion and stand up to enact positive change. You, the graduating class of 2020, have the most opportunity of any other generation prior to you in almost every measurable aspect. Be the change you wish to see, and don't be afraid to take risks to achieve what you've only dreamt about. The future is in your hands, so be proud of where you are today, but always continue to push forward. Thank you for being part of School District 59, Peace River South, with your own individual personalities that brought laughter, tolerance, joy, integrity, trust, and determination.
School is a place where opportunities to try new things and to develop new talents are offered, with the hope that as you move through life, you find those things that challenge and excite you. These moments help you grow and find that unique you. As school trustees, our hope for you all is that you continue to grow and make choices that challenge you. We are confident that all you have learned will guide you through difficult times and that your strengths will move you to where it is that you want to be.
As you move forward in your life, understanding that while your school years are soon behind you, the rest of your future lies in front of you. You've been part of your school community and part of our communities in a bigger way. As your teachers, parents, and guardians have taught you, your generation has trailblazed topics like inclusion and diversity, creating a deep sense of belonging. While you prove to the world, your generation will be the next community leaders, our world is shifting, and you can take great pride in being a large influence. Continue to trailblaze and push boundaries, keep asking questions, and never lose your curiosity. We are proud of your strength and your courage.
School District 59's values speak to fostering learning, modeling teamwork, and showing respect and integrity. You, the class of 2020, have worked hard this year, demonstrating the moral courage needed to make it through this pandemic and to provide an unparalleled model of leadership for the next class of graduates. As a parent of a graduating student, I am overjoyed to know that each of you are crossing this stage today. And while we all wish we could be together, celebrating hand in hand, we want to recognize the resilience and tenacity of the 2020 graduating class in stepping up to receive your diplomas in such a different way. We are so proud of the work that each of you have accomplished.
We, the Board of Education, have been inspired by your determination to express yourselves as individuals and applaud the many unique perspectives and values that you hold true. Now more than ever, the world needs leaders who embrace all diversity, and I am proud to say that I have no doubt you will continue to change the world by openly showing a loving acceptance of all. Stay true to you. Congratulations on this very important milestone, the first of many more to come.
So now it's your turn to write the history of your lives. As Winston Churchill said, history will be kind to me, for I intend to write it. Or you could think of it this way: make sure that you take enough risks in life that there will be some interesting stories for your grandkids, but live safely enough that you will be around to tell them the stories yourself. Congratulations to the class of 2020.
Next, I would like to welcome class representatives Olivia Beamish and Josh Windland with an address to their class.
Good Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Firstly, I would like to express all my gratitude to all the teachers that have gotten me to this point in my life. Without them, I would not be standing here. Today marks a milestone which did not get handed to us. At one time or another, we felt like we could not keep going. But with the support of our parents, friends, and teachers, we have overcome the first step into adulthood. To all the parents, we thank you for putting up with us for 18 years. You have given us a huge chunk of who we are as a person. You taught us to respect other people, be forgiving, and the love that you show us is the love that we show other people. Thank you for allowing us to grow into the unique individuals you see here today.
I will never forget my first day of high school, the very start of the day where you awkwardly stand outside the doors trying to seek out your friends. Also, super happy to be there. Then, as soon as the doors open, you have to be the first one in, or else you're the rotten egg. After you get inside and settle in your classes, you blink. Next thing you know, you're in grade 11, getting ready for the year to end and start grade 12.
As everyone moves on in the next chapter of their life, I will forever remember all the wonderful memories I had at this high school. For example, breaking my arm going up the weight room stairs, first joining MeetAwee and having the time of my life, being able to go to Timmy's for lunch and just barely making it back in time for the bell, waiting to start art class, that building was like a second home for me, and the best one yet, witnessing Moose getting dabbed in the neck by a grade 8 and almost peeing my pants laughing.
This graduation has already shown us how capable we are of accomplishing our goals. I hope all of us here today can take this personal accomplishment as an example of how anything is possible when you put your minds to it. As we continue on in our lives, let us face each new problem with confidence, knowing that we have reached great highs and are equipped with the necessary tools to tackle our future.
Also, a huge thank you to Ms. Singer, Ms. Mounsey, Mr. Mason, Ms. Rivard, and Ms. Henry. Thank you so much for the time you have spent with us, and thank you so much for the time you took to prepare our grad. We will forever be in your debt. Thank you.
Thank you, Olivia and Josh. The valedictorian is a top academic student of the graduating class. This year, the distinction belongs to two students who represent academic excellence at Chetwynd Secondary School. Please welcome Dylan Ethier and Nicole Eddy for their valedictorian's address.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, friends and family, teachers and faculty, but most importantly, my classmates, I'd like to welcome you all to Chetwynd Secondary graduation of 2020. As I stand before you today, I wonder how I made it here. I'm remembering all of the times I thought to myself, I'll just do it later, I guess I'll have to wing it, and at least we're in it together. As I remember all of these times I thought these things to myself, I'm also reminded of the encouraging words that others filled my head with. I want to take a minute to thank those people for keeping me afloat these past 5 years. My mom and dad for always encouraging me to be the strongest, kindest, and best version of myself and absolutely nothing less. My brother, who taught me that hard work truly pays off and you can achieve what you put your mind to. My teachers for putting up with my loud, mouthy comments and guiding me towards academic success through their own passion and drive. Moose, I think I speak for us all when I say that you never failed to make us feel welcome here at Chetwynd Secondary. It's everything from knowing all the hot gossip before we do to grabbing us by the back of the neck and ushering us back to our class from the hallway. If you're like myself, you've been looking forward to your high school graduation forever. Since 2020 sucks so much, this isn't necessarily the way this day was supposed to go for us. Although we're not receiving a traditional graduation ceremony, we shouldn't let that affect how we feel about this milestone in our lives. Sure, we missed out on some things. Yeah, it sucks. But I don't think we should allow the past 3 months to erase 5 years. We started here as kids, and we're still kids, but we did it. We worked hard and we did it. Most of us probably think of graduation as some sort of big ending. Personally, I'd rather think of it as more of a starting point. For the first time in our lives, we get to choose what's next for us. As each of us leaves this ceremony today, we're all beginning a new adventure. For some, it might mean university or college. To some, it might mean working and saving money. Some of us probably don't know what we're going to be doing in the fall, and that's completely okay. This is an exciting time. We're celebrating the past 5 years, but we're also celebrating what comes next. We're all about to set off in different directions, new cities, and new lives. But I think what's best about that is that we all get to embark on this new stage in our lives together. Other than learning that mitochondria is the powerhouse of the cell, high school's taught me some pretty big lessons. I learned one thing that stuck out more than the rest. Never let someone else's opinion of you alter how you feel about yourself. I learned this one pretty quick. High school's a tough place to try and figure yourself out, and we all had to do it. It becomes way too easy to seep into the trends and to change who you are in order to fit in. I'm lucky that I had a strong role model to teach me this lesson, my sister. She constantly inspires me to be the truest version of myself, no matter what others may say or think. And I hope that in all of our future endeavors, we do not allow ourselves to change in order to please someone else. Now that it's all coming to an end, I wish I had more time. I wish I had one more chance to run to Tim Hortons for iced coffee and hope I don't get yelled at if I'm late. I would have said goodbye and thank you to all my teachers who have shaped me into who I am today. I wish I had one more chance to say good luck to all of my classmates. I'm incredibly excited to see where this next step takes us all. I wish you all the best in this new exciting chapter of our lives. Believe it or not, we did it. Congratulations.
Good morning, friends and family, teachers, and most of all, the graduates of the class of 2020. I will begin by thanking my friends and family who have supported me over the years, my mom and dad for teaching me how important it is to work hard at whatever I do, my teachers and school administrators who have motivated me with their enthusiasm, the counselors who have helped me find scholarships and plan for my future, the custodians who have kept our school looking pretty great, even if it does have a few years under its belt. And to Moose, for always grabbing me by the ear and directing me to my appropriate class. This year has been absolutely crazy and filled with so many emotions. From the excitement in September of knowing that graduation was right around the corner, to eventually realizing that today's ceremony was not going to be quite what we were envisioning. But that doesn't change the fact that no matter what has happened, we are still a group of amazing individuals who have worked really hard to get here, and we have lots of great adventures ahead of us. Well, 13 years is a long time with many subjects and a huge amount of learning. What have we discovered? What have we learned? When I was in my grade 11 English class, we had just started a unit on poetry. And to say the least, I am not one to take much interest in poetry, but one of the poems I read called Mother to Son was quite captivating. It spoke about life being like a staircase, filled with tacks and splinters, and making it a difficult and dangerous climb. It's true that every life will have setbacks, and there will be times when giving up feels like the only option. But keep on moving and keep climbing. Yes, yes, I know, Mom, I put in an English reference and not a math one, so this quote is for you. Math may not teach us how to add love or subtract hate, but it gives us hope that every problem has a solution. With some of the tough times that we are going through right now with the coronavirus and nationwide protests, hopefully we'll come out ahead as stronger people. I'm also very excited to be graduating as a dual dogwood student. French immersion has been difficult at times, and sometimes I wanted to curse my parents for putting me into the program. But today I see why they did, and I can appreciate all the amazing benefits of speaking an extra language. I am also grateful to the individuals who worked hard to keep the French program alive. Merci beaucoup, Mr. Vard, for going above and beyond as a French immersion teacher and making this possible. Thank you to my coaches and my teammates. You are all so incredible. Sports are an important aspect of my life because when I step onto that court, I'm doing what I love. I'm going to miss the bus trips, the excitement of tournaments, and the adrenaline rush of close games, even if I am the one that screws it all up. Sports have provided me with smiles and laughter and motivated me to go after the things I love. I'm sure each of us has something that drives us, and being able to share that with friends is something pretty special. I'm excited to see what life brings us as we head off in different directions. We will all face many challenges, so make sure good friends are nearby to help take out the splinters along the way. Always hold your head high, control what you can control, and strive to do what you love. And Whether we like it or not, we are the Chetwynd Secondary COVID Class of 2020. And while I'm up here, I just wanted to say, on behalf of the graduating class, I would like to say a big thank you to Chet TV for recording our ceremonies today. They will be creating a video of the day for each grad to take home, all at no charge. It's amazing to see our community come together and for an event like this. Thank you so much for your generosity.
Thank you, Dylan and Nicole. This section of our program recognizes those individuals who have displayed outstanding performance in specific subject areas and have contributed significantly to student life at Chetwynd Secondary School during the 2019-2020 school year. I am pleased to ask Ms. Ethier to present the Math 12 Awards.
Clearly, to win this award, you have to be good at math. I realized exactly how good this young man was early in the year. He had missed a few days of school for a family commitment, and I asked him to stay after class so that I could help him catch up on what he had missed. Within minutes, he understood absolutely everything we had covered over the previous 2 or 3 days, and I suspected right then that I would be standing here today presenting the Top Math 12 Award to Tristan Gary.
Thank you, Ms. Ethier. We would now like to invite the guest speaker for the grad class, Ms. Rivard.
Oh, the Places You'll Go by Dr. Seuss, adapted by Ms. Rivard and Ms. Portman. Oh, the places you can't go. Congratulations, today is your day. You're off to great places when Dr. Henry says it's okay. You have brains in your head, you have feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself any direction you choose. Just make sure you stay 2 meters apart, and eventually they say things will restart. You'll look up and down streets, look them over with care. About some you will say, I don't choose to go there. With your head full of brains and a mask on your face, you're too smart to go into any unsanitized place. And in that case, of course, you'll head straight out of there. Just make sure you wash your hands with care. Oh, the places you'll go eventually. Now, on a more serious note, there's a quote by Salvador Dali that says, "Do not fear perfection, for you will never reach it." I think it's accurate for you as you embark on your journey. Don't worry about following what other people might think is the perfect path, as there is no such thing. The rest of your life is wide open, and the options are endless. On your journey, you might hit some bumps in the road. You might backtrack a little. You might get to a fork in the road, choose one path, and then come back and do the other. Or you may even do a full U-turn and try again. All those options are okay. You need to do what's right for you, and as long as you keep trucking along, everything will work out. You don't know where you'll end up, but stay positive, take chances, and it will be worth it. Remember, it takes all kinds to succeed. Diversity is key. There are over a million different species of animals in the world, and they are all successful in their own way. From the unassuming sponge who filters gallons of water for food, to the arthropod with their jointed legs, and even the flatworms with their double daggers. They found what made them special, and they went with it. You should do the same. Find what makes you happy, which in itself means you're successful, and fight for it. Family and friends, at this time, the grads need roots and wings. Roots to keep them grounded, keep them safe, and to know you'll be there for them no matter what. But they also need wings. Wings to soar, wings to achieve, and wings to know they can do anything they set their mind to. I hope CSS has helped to provide you with roots and wings so you are prepared for this next step. I have loved getting to know all of you, and you've helped me learn and grow as a teacher, coach, and person. I look forward to the visits and updates in the following years. It's a great big world out there, and you're ready to rock it. Congratulations, you did it, COVID style. Thank you. That's it.
Thank you, Ms. Rivard. I would now like to acknowledge the tremendous support from our community and outside contributors in their granting of scholarships and bursaries to the students of Chetwynd Secondary School. I would like to thank Ms. Dixie for putting a tremendous amount of time and energy into making sure that the students apply for bursaries and scholarships, and that the contributors are involved in the process. I would also like to thank the members of the awards committee for their role in the process. I would now like to ask Ms. Dixie to come forward to acknowledge the recipients of the scholarships and bursaries.
We're so fortunate to live in such a generous community. In the three groups, there's over $38,000 that's given to grads in order for them to reach their post-secondary school goals. The Chetwynd Chamber of Commerce, Madison Webb. Chetwynd and District Minor Hockey, Davis Schmidt. Chetwynd Forest Industries, Madison Webb. Chetwynd Masonic Lodge, Dustin Hayward. Chetwynd Secondary School PAC, Madison Webb. Little Giant Figure Skating Club, Madison Webb. Ministry Scholarship, Dustin Hayward. Peace River Regional District, Tristan Gary. Unifor Local 449, Madison Webb. Windrum Elementary School, Davis Schmidt. The Royal Canadian Legion, Dustin Hayward. Grads, when the ceremony is over, you'll have envelopes on the side with all of your paperwork. Please make sure you pick it up.
Thank you, Ms. Dixie. Congratulations, everyone. I would now like to acknowledge the dual credit students, the BCIT and the NLC certificates, and Davis Schmidt with heavy duty mechanics. Congratulations on your achievement. The grads have put together a slideshow that they would now like to share with you all. And they're just going to get that set up here right away. So as Ms. Dixie was saying, grads, make sure all of your scholarship packages that you have are going to be over here ready for you to take with you at the end of the grad ceremony today, okay?
Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Henry. Just before I begin my closing remarks for this morning's first of three ceremonies, I would like to let everyone in the audience know what's going to happen next. After my closing remarks, the graduates will leave the stage and eventually move to you in the audience, their family, at which at that point in time, they'll either remove their cap and gown if they so desire to reveal their fancy garments that they're wearing underneath, or remain in their cap and gown and have an opportunity for what we would have traditionally done as a first dance with you, their parents. Grads, I promised I would keep my remarks brief, and I will. To the graduating class of 2020, I want you to know you have been one of the most focused and organized grad classes that I can recall in my time here at CSS. I would like to thank all the grads and the parents who worked so hard over the year to make their vision of grad attainable. I would like to acknowledge the work of the young women and men who have spent hours in here in the last week to make this space look the way that it does. Your efforts did not go unnoticed. I would also like to thank the staff who have stepped in to help decorate, Mrs. Mounsey, Mrs. Henry, Mr. Mold, to Mrs. Singer and Mrs. Newells for all the support you provide to the grad class over the year, and Ms. Rivard for your effort and time that you put into being their grad coordinator. I think it's safe to say no one in this room could have predicted how these last 3 months have turned out, which unfortunately has led to the vision you had for grad not being fully attained. As upsetting as that might be to all of us here today, and to those who had wanted to be here but cannot be here due to the restrictions that we're dealing with, we have all learned an important life lesson. As organized and planned as you might be, there can always be an unforeseen obstacle that gets in your way. You could have all thrown your hands in the air and given up. Instead, what you did was adapt to what was given to you, focus on your future, balance work and school responsibilities, support each other and the adults in your life through this tough time, and most impressively, persevere to reach this significant milestone in your life. After speaking with a number of you, I know that you have some uncertainty about what the next phase of your life might look like now. Plans are changing, and perhaps new opportunities will arise. If that makes you nervous, that's okay, because I know you have the resiliency, grit, and strength to handle anything thrown at you. Sitting here today proves that. You wouldn't let a pandemic, a global pandemic, stop you from graduating. You've proven that you can do anything you want if you work hard and stay positive. On a personal note, I will miss the conversations about what is going on in your life, both the good and the not so great. I will also miss the random parkour moments in the parking lot, chasing you to class, as been mentioned a few times today, and watching you continue to grow into the young, amazing adults that I know you'll become. It's been a pleasure getting to spend the last 5 years with you. Please know that I believe in each one of you and that we are proud to call you graduates. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor at this time to present to you the Chetwynd Secondary School Class of 2020.
The days come easy and the moments pass slow, and each road leads you where you wanna go. And if you're faced with a choice and you have to choose, I hope you choose the one that means the most to you. And if one door opens to another door closed, I hope you keep on walking till you find the window. If it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. But more than anything, my wish for you is that this life becomes all that you wanted to. Your dreams stay big, your worries stay small. You never need to carry more than you can hold. And while you're out there getting where you're getting to, I hope you know somebody loves you and wants the same thing. Yeah, this is my
So grads, if you're wanting to get out of your cap and gown, feel free to do so. And we'll give you 2 to 3 minutes to do that, freshen up, and then we'll come back here for the first dance. Okay, graduates, if you could grab a parent or guardian, it's time for the first dance.
I hope the days come easy and the moments pass slow, and each road leads you where you want to go. And if you're faced with a choice and you have to choose, I hope you choose the one that means the most to you. And if one door opens to another door closed, I hope you keep on walking till you find the window. If it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. More than anything, my wish for you is that this life becomes all that you want it to. Your dreams stay big, your worries stay small. You never need to carry more than you can hold. And while you're out there getting where you get to, I hope you know somebody loves you and wants the same things too. Yeah, this is my wish. I hope you never look back, but you never forget all the ones who love you in the place you left. I hope you always forgive and you never regret, and you help somebody every chance you get. Oh, you find God's grace in every mistake, and always give more than you take. But more than anything, yeah, more than anything, my wish for you is that this life becomes all that you want.